Now the stage is set for the biggest and most spectacular dance extravaganza in Africa. It is Rum in the Jungle 2018, and this year the event promises to be bigger, better and more explosive than ever before. You're about to witness some of the finest dancers from around the world gather here in Sun City, South Africa, to compete and leave their hearts on the dance floor. I'm your host, Mr. Colin Donsko, for All Access, and I invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. Play something these pros are lying. Play something. Play something. Play something. We have all the people participating from our own province, from other provinces, from outside the country, from even international countries. For us as the Northwest, it's a privilege for us to be hosting this magnitude of an event that says to the world, Northwest, when we started long, long time ago and make dance as a key in Mabana, one of our institutions, we have produced Abotebogo Kgobokwe. We've got another lady who's the tourism ambassador in Germany. She's from here, around the villages here in Rustenburg. So for me, Rumba in the Jungle got lost along the way. It has come back home.
We're bringing it back home,
back
right?
Home. It belongs here. It doesn't belong anywhere else. You can see the excitement when you go around Sun City. Sun City is a city within a city, in a village. You get my point? Now people are seeing something they've never seen before. As tourism, we are so excited because this means contribution to the GDP of the province. Accommodations are full. People are getting into garages to fill petrol. People are eating. For me, the people who have arrived here, they are coming to inject something in our GDP. Is that it, for us as the government of the Northwest, we are so excited.
MEC, how important is an event like this for the development of dance in the continent?
For me, it's very big. You'd remember that not everybody can dance, you know, and it's a skill that you develop as you grow, and you need to be trained for the skill to grow. And what is good about it? I'm bringing a different skill, a new thing, and it goes far. They can compete in any platform in the globe. And that is a huge benefit for them. And it's a pride for most of them to be seen in on TV, to be seen in this platform, interacting with the world. It changed the mindset. When they go back, they want to go and enjoy their time. And this, I'm saying, we must emphasize this in our school so that we are able to keep our young ones. The growing mind is very dangerous when you leave it to go around. But when we keep them indoors and show them the beauty of this dance as one of them, I'm definitely you will have a better generation.
Guys, I'm not a dancer, but when this MEC speaks, I feel like I just want to dance and move.
What do you say to these young aspiring dancers and entrepreneurs in the province and in the country? What do you advise them to do?
I'm advising them never to underestimate the talent that they have. Never to underestimate what they are doing. With dance, you can go far. There is a lot of money in this business. It's not just dancing. You are making money while you are enjoying yourself. You get my point?
There's glitz, there's glam, and there's the opportunity to make money.
JP.
And we're competing in Adult Championship Latin American at Rumba in the Jungle this year.
It's an honor to be here. The competition is fierce and we're really enjoying it.
Yeah, and we're going on the floor right now. So bye.
Yeah.
Yeah. As one of the adjudicators, what are you looking for on the dance floor from these dancers that have come here from around the world?
Yes, yes, yes. We're looking for technical quality, movement to music, choreography presentation, and of course partnering with your partner. Especially with this event called the Rumba in the Jungle, we get to see many couples from overseas coming to this competition where they come in and our dancers get to see them and they start lifting their dancing up as well and putting in more effort, more practice.
Yeah. As we can see right next to us, we've got the number 2 ranked couple in the world just going on to do a show. But I think what we can expect further on in the competition, we finished the standard already, but the Latin, most exciting sections of the evening. So yeah. Yeah. It's been fantastic judging it throughout
the day. As one of the adjudicators, what is it that you're looking for in the dancers here this evening?
We're looking for the 4 main elements within the dance disciplines, the standard Latin disciplines, which is technical quality, partnering skill, movement to music, and of course choreography and presentation. Those are the 4 main elements that we all as adjudicators sort of look for in our own specific ways. So yeah, the couples that demonstrate that, of course coupled with their X factor, fantastic.
Yeah. What is your advice to new kids on the block? So young aspiring dancers who just entered this industry. What do you say to them?
Look, this is such a neutral industry. It's a gender neutral. It knows no age. You can start at any age. You don't have to fit a specific mold. You don't have to conform to the stereotypical, oh, I need to be skinny or etc. etc. It's so inclusive. So this is the way the future is going. I live in Europe. And Germany particularly, it's just buzzing. It's an ongoing, growing industry. And I mean, coming back to South Africa occasionally, see the incredible, incredible, I can't stop saying incredible talent that there is here. It's just scary what could grow.
Take it. No, you wanna see me naked, naked, naked. I wanna be a baby, baby, baby. Spinning in his wedges like he came from Mayday. Rock a wristed on the ground. Like, when I get like this, I can't be royal. I'm too little to dim down a notch. Cause I can name some things that I'm gon' do. Wow, wow, wow. Wow, wow, wow. Thoughts. Wow.
But Dasha, what does it take to prepare for an event that is this big?
It takes a lot of time and practice every day for many, many hours. And plus, also we go to the gym, we prepare our body to be strong enough to dance, yes, to look good. And it's a lot of things.
How does a dance couple who is just dancing as a profession, how do they maintain not getting lost in that space when it's such a close contact?
It's not difficult. You're not shy and you're just doing your job. So we are like actors too.
Like you're acting, you're performing. Dasha, did you fall in love with him on the dance floor?
Actually, when he was dancing with another partner, yes. Of course, if you are not together, then you are traveling together. No, you're every day together and somehow you are connecting with each other.
Play something these pros alive. Play something.
The excitement is only because every single thing was positive. Every single thing was bigger and better. Every single dream we've had is being achieved. nations from around the world. They were competing right with us, the international adjudicators. It was just phenomenal. The performance by Stefano and Dasha, they're second in the world. They're knocking on the world championship door, and here they are with us. Every single thing was stunning. We've gone up by so many notches. People from other federations have said it's time that we all come together as one nation to dance.
And that's where we want to, that's where we want to head in the future. But I know you're one of the kings of dance in Africa. You've been in this game for many, many years. How far have we come in terms of development?
We want to feel an industry that's moving, that's energized, that's powerful. And it happened. This place brought it together. Rumba in the Jungle 2018. Oh my God, big memory for me.
What was your highlight of this weekend?
Well, my highlight happened today. There was a wheelchair performance, and by coincidence, I walked into them in the entrance. They said to me, Harold, we're struggling, and we need money. And I didn't know what to say, and I looked at them, and all I could say was, write it down. They wrote it down. I went on stage. During their performance, I thought it's time I'm saying this, and I said it. I said, guys, this girl is 13. She's had more than 44 operations. Look at her power, look at her courage. And guess what? I said, she has dreams to go international.
Yes. Wow.
I said, they need money and sponsorships. Who has an idea? And I left it at that. Within 5 minutes, there was a guy that walked up there and said, I'm giving them 20,000 rand.
And this is the kind of game changers we need in the dance industry. Let's talk about Africa's dance future. Where do you see? What do you see?
Oh my God, Africa is the continent of dance. Africa is so rich, the diversity of styles, the coming together, the genres, so many genres. It's Africa. I mean, so all that must be revered. That is the important thing. Nothing must be excluded. All inclusive, and Africa will buzz the world. We are known. I've lived in Europe for 11 years. I always have heard Africa is the continent of music, soul, and dance.
Actually attract good sponsors to come and assist us. But what is important is that we want to put a world-class show. Now I'm happy that with the judges that we have employed from around the world, all of them, they are commending this event. They are saying it is even much better than other international events, which gives me courage. Therefore, it is a brand already. Now, when you have a brand, what you need to have is to have a good sponsor, to have people that can put money into it. Because this will then assist to bring back our social program, our social cohesion, which is the emphasis that I've been putting forward. To say, for us to come back as a nation and be a disciplined nation, away from crime, away from drugs, we need to bring back social programs as the drivers of building the nation.
Franz, one of the highlights here, one of the key features here this weekend is that you really had the developmental aspect from not only dance but fashion. You had an exhibit happening or an exhibition happening right here, a fashion show, which tells me that you're thinking about more than just what happens on the dance floor. How do we invite people who are not yet in the space, how do we invite them into the industry and say that there is enough opportunity for you as well?
No, perhaps I should say this event is no longer a dance event. It's a lifestyle event.
Yes.
People should come here not only to think about dancing. They should come here to have a multiple of opportunities. We are putting that as one of the key elements to put to the market, especially our market that we are attracting. But it is more than that. We want to marry dancing with fashion, because dancing is about glamour. It's about the fashion. It's about looking good. Therefore, we want to make sure that we capture that market before somebody else can actually say, oh, we are losing on another opportunity. We'll be right back.
Nhlanhla from Mafiki Zolo, and I am saying yes to dance, yes to fashion, yes to music, and of course, yes to Rumba in the Jungle. You can't love glitz and glam. I think most dancers, both male and female, that are dancing love the bit of glam. Yes. It actually adds a spark and a sizzle to you. I think it's magical. I believe in careers within the arts, so I believe in coaches of the future that won't be me, but better than me. So I'm hoping that in 10 years' time, there'll be somebody standing here that is like 10 times or 100 times a better version of me. This evening, well, a showcase like no other. We've got the number two couple in the world. Yes, Stefano and Dasha, the best of the best technical dancing you could ever see. Like if you want slick, if you want the highest level of dance, tonight is the place to be. And then on top of it, we get to see our very own South African dancers kill it on the dance floor, our best, and there's nothing as magical as that, because I think South African dancers are pretty special.
I think it's amazing. It's social and pro-am today, but they've had their own gala event. Awesome show by world finalists Stefano and Dasha. I think that's been absolutely amazing. And Italian vocalists Damiano and Sirana. I think the dancers have been fabulously entertained and they are very excited.
I know you've had a jam-packed 4 days of dance, entertainment, development, and loads more. Where we're taking Rumba in the Jungle, what does the future of this event look like?
I think future of Rumba in the Jungle, next thing we bring the world professional Latin back to South Africa. We've done it before in 2008, so I think we want to step up on it. And I think now that there's a lot of faith and unity in South Africa, everybody's excited. So I think that's where we're elevating Rumba in the Jungle to.
Marin, this year was the first time that you incorporated not only dance, but development and fashion and the entrepreneurial aspect of what this industry offers. What is that all about, and how did this relationship with the Northwest province come about?
I think it's absolutely amazing. I think Rumba in the Jungle, 16 countries across the world. I think in terms of what we're doing for the region, in terms of social economic benefits, development of dance, development of culture, bringing the world to Rumba, I think it's wonderful. Lots of tourists, lots of opportunities, work opportunities for Northwest. So I think it's been absolutely amazing. And I think it's all integrated. I think the fashion show is again the local cultural talent, you know, integrating culture, lifestyle, dance. It couldn't be more amazing.
And that concludes Rumba in the Jungle 2018. From the most spectacular dance performances to fashion, development and live entertainment, it all came together right here in Sun City, South Africa. Now don't forget to join us next time on your favorite lifestyle and entertainment channel as we give you all access to all things spectacular in South Africa.